So the right solution here is this. So what is generated to go up a bit, because it's half empty, the result, here we are. So for every combination of proteins, he calculates the distance between the proteins. That's what you see here. So it's kind of half of a matrix that contains the distances between all the pairs of proteins that you can have. And then you use this as an input for the hierarchical clustering function. And you tell him, I want to do average linkage and not complete linkage, because complete linkage is the default, but it's not the best choice. So this will perform the clustering. Now, that brings me back to the documentation of the pheatmap function. So the pheatmap function has a lot of arguments, and you see that many of these arguments, all these, the ones that are in blue now, they're all related to the clustering, to the method that is used for clustering. So you see that he uses Euclidean distances, yeah, Euclidean, and he uses complete linkage. That's what this is. So if you want to the pheatmap function to also use average linkage instead of complete linkage, you have to change this argument. You have to set it equal to average. Yeah? And then it will do exactly the same as what we have done here. So typically you also change this, because average clustering is better than complete clustering. Okay. So, and then you have to convert this result of the hierarchical clustering into a dendrogram, so a tree structure. How can you do this? Well, you use the dendExtend package, and then you use the as.dendrogram function. It will convert this into a dendrogram. And once you have a dendrogram, you can use the cut tree method. So that's exactly the same function that, if I can see it here, that the pheatmap function is also using. So the cut tree arguments that you set here are related to the same cut tree function that I'm using now. So what am I saying here? Well, cut the tree into four groups, into four clusters. Why four? Because that's what I did here also, yeah, on the heat map. I asked for four clusters for my proteins. So I'm just going to do this, only this. And you see what it does? For every protein, it will tell me which cluster it belongs to.